Hello, brethren. Good morning today. I open this day in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, whom we soak our blood and our soul rest on. Today, our reading is coming from the book of John, chapter 21, verse 1. Then we will go down to 13 or before 13. So the theme of the reading today is Jesus and the miraculous catch of fish. Afterward, Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Tiberias. It happened this way: Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples were here together. "I'm going out to fish," Simon Peter told them, and they say, "We'll go with you." So they went out, got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, "Friends, haven't you any fish?" "No," they answered. He said, "Throw your nets on the right side of the boat and you will find some." When they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large number of fish. Then the disciples, whom Jesus loved, said to Peter, "It is the Lord." As soon as Simon Peter heard him say, "It is the Lord," he wrapped his outer garment around him, for he had taken it off, and jumped into the water. The other disciples followed in the boat, towing the net full of fish, for they were not far from shore, about 100 yards. When they landed, they saw a fire of burning coals there with fish on it and some bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." Simon Peter climbed aboard and dragged the net ashore. Was full of large fish, 153. But even with so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." One of the disciples dared ask him, "Who are you?" They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came, took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from the dead. So, brethren, Jesus lives. Even when your faith, my faith, is about to fail us, he's always by our side to tap you and say, "I'm still alive." Things of the end time might be happening, but Jesus never said he will forsake his chosen ones. He said, "The believers, I am there with you." Even when the road seems so hard that you seem to give up, the frustration mounts so hard that nowhere to turn to, he said, "Be patient, I always give you directions." Always be in spirit so you know when the Lord talks to you. He talks to everyone. No one is special in his eyes. We are all special. He loves our souls. He loves us as our faces differ. No one is more handsome or more beautiful in the face of the Lord, no. So, whenever you are in doubt, pray to God. Don't read the Word of God as you read your novels or your books to pass exams, no. Study that the Holy Spirit teaches you, directs you, and breaks every yoke in your life with every word. Every word in the world that God has given us, the manual, which is the scripture, has a very profound power behind them. If you can tap into the word, one word from the word of God, you say, "I have heard this word 1,000 times. Why did it change me today?" Every word of God is enough to heal your broken heart. I know what you're going through. Sometimes you say, "Who do I know to call? Where do I know to go? I've gone out, I've done many things, I've searched." But he is by your side, he smiles, and he asks you, "Have you ever lacked your daily bread?" How do you know it comes? No one can say. Even the rich can give answer to that. So I pray today that the Jesus Christ, who is the miraculous fish catcher, who always catch the fish and give us the bread that we eat with it, for our daily life until he fulfills that which he has said unto our life. Always be a testimony to the word of God wherever you go. Preach the gospel in your daily activities, in your daily living. Live like Christ. That's the only religion he knows. Love. With no expectation. Because he is always there. He said, I'll provide for you everything you need when you need it. I pray for you today and I pray for myself today that whatever we lack, whatever we desire in our spiritual life to uplift us, to make us whole, and to live in health, in spirit, to serve God, to serve Jesus in truth, and to inherit heaven at last. I pray that we be fulfilled in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you today as you go out to face your endeavors. Don't fail to subscribe to our channel, like us, comment, send your requests, for there is no God who does it. You have the faith, I have the faith. Who can make it happen? Thank you for watching.